All right, so let's begin the live session today. This is the fifth in the series of current affairs and geography. And in the last four, we did the topics related to physical geography. So this is going to be on human geography from now onwards in the next four lectures. So in human geography, first of all, today we are doing, this is fifth in the series, which is on agriculture. So today we are going to discuss questions, concepts related to agriculture in the current affairs and geography. So I welcome you all to this live session on the Geoecologist. Thank you for joining me live. And let me know in the comment box that if you can hear me clearly, if my video is clear to you, and then we can start our discussion. So good evening to everyone. So let me know in the comment box that if you can see the live session now. All right. So we have, and good evening to all of you, Shalu, Mukesh. All right, so people have joined in. And just few more seconds and then we can start with the discussions for today. So as I said, today we are doing this human geography portion right from today. And I hope the audio visual is all fine. So thank you for telling me this, and just in few seconds we are going to start. So we are waiting for a few more people to join in and then we can begin. So if you have not watched the previous sessions, that was all based on physical geography from session 1 to session 4, right from geomorphology to climate to oceanography to environment. All those aspects have been covered in the first four sessions, right? And then today we are doing this human geography, we are beginning with it, out of which first, that is session number 5, we are doing on agriculture special today, right? So now let's begin with the session. So first topic that I have selected here is, which was a news known as banana grit. Now this is something which is important, grating of pieces, particles like this, if you can observe. So this is banana grit that you observe here in this image. Now scientists at CSIR, National Institute of Interdisciplinary Science and Technology, NIIST, right? And the place is called Papanamakkod, right? So this place in Kerala. So Papanamakkod is in Kerala, where you have this particular product being processed. And this was in news. And the banana variety that is being used for this is called Nendran banana, right? So Nendran banana is important variety, and this product that has been processed out of this banana is also very similar to what you say is rava, right? Suji that you say. So broken wheat variety, similar to that. So it means this is another product that is important and also very human friendly, you can say health friendly, right? So this concept was introduced to utilize the presence of resistant starch in bananas. This is important here to catch, right? To actually utilize the presence of resistant starch in bananas, which is reported to improve the gut health. Your stomach health improves by consuming this. So that's really important. And now this banana is consumed in ripe variety as well, and also in other dishes like avial and thoran. These are the dishes in Kerala where this is being used earlier also. So this grit, or what you say is granules, right? The grains that we say can be used for making upma, or it can be mixed with, you know, various powders and porridges, and coconut milk and healthy drinks can also be made out of this. So banana powder, this is the granules or the grit, is also important where you have baking, that is cake making or bread preparation and all those things. So this is basically one product coming from bananas, which was in news, banana grit that we say. So that's important. Then comes something that you should allocate with or associate with this when you're talking about bananas in India, right? Because banana grit was in news, maybe some other variety of banana can be asked as a question. So little about what kind of varieties do we have in India. So one of them is called ice cream banana tree, right? This variety here, you see, this looks like ice cream. It's also called blue java, something like a bluish color is here, right? So this is a blue java variety. Then you have manzano banana, right? Which is also called apple banana, if you observe here. Right, then you have something called Cavendish banana, and Cavendish banana is the most widely circulated banana. If you see, this is the most wide variety of banana in commercial circulation. Then you have dwarf variety of the same Cavendish, right, which is not very huge tree, right? That is important. Then in India we also have dwarf plantain, which is also called Puerto Rican plantain banana, right? So this is the dwarf one. Now Gros Michel is also called Big Mike banana, which is native from Costa Rica, which is also grown in India. Then you have red banana variety, also grown in India, which is very famous in Asia, South America, and East Africa as well. And then you have this Grand Nain banana and Robusta, very famous. So these are the commercial 9 or 10 types of variety of bananas in India, and some of it that we'll see. So this is Chiquita banana, the name of Nain banana is also known as this. Now Naini banana and Robusta banana is very famous. Bhusawal banana is very famous in India. Now why we are talking about bananas? Because one is banana grit was in news, and second, one disease was also in news. Now this is this Panama disease that you must have seen or may have observed in news, right? So this is a fungal disease in banana plant, right? And the wilt, the name here is Fusarium wilt. So it's basically a wilt which is popularly known as Panama disease and afflicts banana plants. If you observe, banana plants have this fungal. And this strain of virus is also called TR4 or tropical race 4. Tropical fruit banana is. So you have tropical race 4, that is the strain of virus that leads to this Panama disease, right? Also called Fusarium wilt. Now for the first time, what is important here is that Indian scientists have brought out a biopesticide that can control this disease, right? That's important here. So the diseases are affecting which type of banana? The Cavendish variety that we saw, the most famous one, that is G9 banana, and that is the most widely grown banana variety, the Cavendish ones, and that is also grown widely in India. So now this spread in India is going to be controlled by Indian scientists' own measurements, that you know, biopesticide. So this is spread in India. If you observe here now, this is important here. In India, more than 60% of bananas are this G9 variety only, Cavendish ones. And the names Grand Naini, Robusta, Bhusawal, Basrai, Srimant, all these names are of this G9 variety only, regional names, local names that you observe. So this could be one of the potential questions which could be asked. And farmers, at least in 4 Indian states, Bihar, Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh, and Uttar Pradesh, have been growing this and have been facing the disease as well. So now this Panama disease is, which was part of the news, and also in India, in Cavendish variety, it's very famous, whose different varieties are, or names are, the Grand Naini, Robusta, Bhusawal, Basrai, and Srimant. That's important here. Now, comes to the other news related to this is another, that is, or the origin part, or you can say the distribution part, that this, you know, fungal infection in banana is exactly like a pandemic that is there, right? So this Panama pandemic that you observe is not new. It has now spread to almost 18 countries of the world since 1970. And inception, if you observe here, you see Southeast Asia, Taiwan. So Taiwan is the origin source, if you observe, and from here you have different countries at different points of time, and this report is given by Food and Agricultural Organization. So this map becomes really important. So hello, who have joined us late, Vikas, Superhuman Returns, and all of you. So let's discuss furthermore. Now the third point here is India and its drought status. Now drought was also in news, and it keeps coming in news whenever you have this ENSO phenomena associated with it, and you know, climate change associated with it. So India's drought status was in news, and the news is 42% of India's land is facing drought situation, and 6% is exceptionally dry. That's important. That was part in news. And drought early warning system, it is called DEWS, that is what could be asked, is there for the warning, right? Now this has been monitoring and warning has been done. So which states are in Gujarat, Jharkhand, Karnataka, Maharashtra, some parts in northeastern states, and Rajasthan, Tamil Nadu, and Telangana. These are the states where almost 500 million people are hit because of drought situation. That's where this 42% thing was in news. And also Food and Agricultural Organization, remember, in banana as well, in definitely in agricultural sector, it's important to know a little about Food and Agricultural Organization. So FAO is something which you should know a little about. It's part of the UN that we already know, United Nations Specialized Agency, where it talks about food security, right? And it's also part of our Sustainable Development Goal, nutrition security and food security. So the motto is, let there be bread for everyone, right? So 1945 onwards, it's there. And one of the important programs that you should see here is Globally Important Agricultural Heritage Systems, GIAHS, and Plant Treaty, which you should go to FAO's website and check for that, if this could be one potential question, because FAO was in news. Then now comes to tomato, and this is something called Tiranga. Now this is important, that tomato growers of Maharashtra complained about that 50 to 60% of their crop was lost due to this new viral disease called Tiranga, right? So kind of tricolor disease, or you can say different strands of virus infecting. So this was mainly because of intensive breeding and cultivation under controlled environment, and they may have created as said by the scientists of Indian Council of Agricultural Research. So this was also in news, Tiranga, and basically affecting tomato, right? And tomato has this pigment called lycopene, which makes it red. Lycopersicum esculentum is the name, botanical name if you know it, right? That's important. Then comes the fifth one, is fight for Aroma Basmati rice GI tag. Now this has been in news for last about 2-3 years now. So this was again because now Pakistan has challenged this, India's claim that, you know, basmati rice is Indian. So 2/3 of world basmati export in terms of market share is with India and rest is with Pakistan. So Pakistan decided to contest this application, right, of GI tag, and in where? In EU's Council on Quality Schemes for Agricultural and Food Stuff, this place, right? So this is important here, that India controls 2/3 of the market of the world, and Indian Agricultural and Processed Food Products Export Development Authority, APEDA, is the organization that has given the GI tag for basmati in 83 districts of India. How many? 83. In which states? Himachal, Punjab, Haryana, Uttarakhand, Delhi, Uttar Pradesh, and J&K. About the states and districts and where this is, you know, produced as a GI tag, as the cultural component, as the unique product. That's important here, right? And then you also have some things that is related to agriculture. Again, is colored cotton that comes into news. After 3 decades of research, 30 years and more research have been done. Now we are, you know, under this trials of producing colored cotton in India, right? So colored cotton in India, if you observe, have been under trial, and which places? Now you can see on the map where this colored cotton of this G. hirsutum variety and Arboreum, G. arboreum, two varieties have been under test. So you observe Surat, Nanded, Dharwar, Khandwa, Nagpur, Lam, Nandyal, and Coimbatore. These are the places where it's on trial, and researchers are conducting trials for 16301DB and DDCC1 varieties, which will yield brown cotton lint. That's important, this brown cotton here, right? So two varieties are there. So one of the varieties, this 16301DB, is ICAR's Central Institute for Cotton Research at Nagpur's, you know, Maharashtra's production, and the other one, DDCC1, is Dharwad's production, University of Agricultural Sciences, Dharwad. That's important here, right? Then widespread fungal infection was also news in apples, right? So the scab disease, which is very common disease although, but what was important here is this intensity of disease. The scientific name, if you see, is Venturia inequalis, and that is related to widespread fungal infection in apple that hit Kashmir Valley, and you know, it was worst in 35 years for the business. So that is what is important here, the scab disease for apple, and Venturia inequalis is what it is called scientifically. So that's important here. Now comes another thing, if you look into the map, so here is India and other places around Southeast Asia. So you observe local veterinarians have looked into this and identified this lumpy skin disease called LST. Now it's a viral disease happening in cattle and buffaloes, right? So officials say what, 30 to 40 cases have been reported from each affected state since the outbreak in 2019, right? And LST is not new. It was earlier only confined to African countries, and it was discovered in 1929. But now the spread is almost the entire South Indian states, completely Central India as well, and some portions nearby in Delhi and Haryana region, and also the Northeastern region, right? So this is what was in news, and also part of livestock census, and also under FAO report 2020. So this was also news, this LSD lumpy skin disease news, right? Now the next one is in today's list is Udupi turmeric. Now Udupi turmeric is very unique turmeric, and it is on the verge of extinction. That's why it was in news. And why it is very unique? Because it is growing on rock outcrops, right? It grows on rocks if you see in the images, right? So this is also known as curcuma, right? So curcuma bhati is scientific word. It's basically curcuma is for ginger family. So this is one variety also known as simply Udupi turmeric, and it was found in the hills and rocky outcrops in Udupi district of Karnataka. And in 1976, it was discovered by Indian Botanical Society, and then it was named this, what you say is Paracotyla bhati. And later on, the taxonomist who was involved in this research and, you know, discovery was K. Gopal Krishna Bhatt. So bhati, the bhati word that you see, the bhat is what is here, right? So Indian Botanical Society. So this is under, you know, threat now. It is on almost on the verge of extinction, Udupi turmeric. That was why, you know, its conservation practices and things are under news, right? So this is important here. And then if you observe, one more fact associated to this Udupi turmeric is very important. In general, you know, if you look at it, it looks just like a grass, a very small thing. So Udupi turmeric is the smallest plant in ginger family. This is important to consider. It resembles any ordinary grass until August and September months when it starts flowering. So season is August and September, right? So that is also important to consider here. Now, ninth important thing, this is India's first agricultural export facilitation center, you know, is going to be set up at Pune. So in 2018, India launched agri export policy that we know, and the target is to make these exports to $60 billion by 2020, the next year, right? So the idea is this facilitation center is going to help in achieving this target. So this is at Pune, that is important. And the 10th and important point is World Bee Day that we celebrate on 20th of May, you know, observed by United Nations. And this World Bee Day is on the name of, you know, in the name of, if you say, to commemorate Anton Jansa, who was a Slovenian national and a pioneer in modern day beekeeping techniques. So that's important. Related to this bees is apiculture, or what you say is apiary, or, you know, production in bee yard that we say. So that's important. And this year's theme, 2021's theme, is important. Be engaged, let's build back better for bees. This is the theme for World Bee Day 2021, and date is 20th May, that was it observed. So these are the things related to agriculture, if you observe in last just about 1 year or so, which was very important. And we'll be taking more topics related to environment and other portions also in the human geography aspect, which is majorly talking in terms of agriculture, horticulture and other aspects. And then we'll also look into factors related to urbanization, urban development, regional development, what all things have been, you know, there in the news related to those part of geography in human geography series now. So we'll have the other sessions also. And I think environmental, okay, so Hira, environmental settings and all those things related to environment, whatever videos I had to make for UPSC geography optional, I have already done on environmental geography. Now the rest of them for paper 2, which you, if you see in geography of India, that is only going to be done after human geography is complete, right? And generally my sessions happen at 5 or 5:30 in the evening, these live sessions. So you can keep looking at it. If you are a subscriber, you'll definitely get this, you know, notification when I'm doing my live session, so you can look into it. And your any other request, as I also posted in the community, Shalu, as you are requesting that practical geography for UGC NET. See, I'm not running this organization like, you know, I don't have 10 people. I'm single person running everything. I have my paid courses. I'm doing this live session. I'm doing recorded videos for YouTube. So you understand that one time I can only take one thing. So right now I am only doing human geography, where economic geography has already begun in parallel to these live sessions. So by Friday, when these live sessions are done, after that, again, economic geography will be completed and subsequently human geography. After that, I will be taking practical geography and geography of India and other series as per your requests. All right. So I hope you understand how the work is going on. So till then, keep watching, keep sharing these videos on live sessions, and you can find this PDF of what I have shared in this video right now in the live session at my Telegram channel with the same name, The Geoecologist. So I'll share the PDF right away after the session there. You can watch, you can take it from there, and you can take a revision of all the topics that I've covered. And you can join me on Instagram for day-to-day updates. I keep doing Instagram live for your discussions. Many times people feel that I don't reply on YouTube because there are so many comments. I sometimes fail to reply on YouTube, but generally in Insta live, it can be a discussion. You can ask a question, you can talk about, you have some doubts, we can talk about it. So try and follow me on Instagram and join my Insta live whenever I'm doing it, so that we can talk about it. We can have a video conferencing over that also on Instagram 101. So you can join me on Instagram the same name everywhere. I have the one name called the Geoecologist. So on Instagram as well, on Telegram as well, you'll find me. On Facebook also, my page is called the Geoecologist. So you can find me on other social medias as well. So I hope you enjoyed the session for today. In the next session, we'll bring on some more topics from human geography part of current affairs. So till then, signing off. Take care, guys. All the best wishes. Keep sharing, keep learning. All the best to all the aspirants for preliminary examination. Take care. Bye-bye.